big day today, as every day has to be a big day today. Using the spell formula, all right? Many times a day I use this. And I said, wait a minute, I've forgotten. What's going on? And I said, oh, I'm under a spell. And then I said, oh, spell. Okay, spell. What does that stand for? S. What does S mean? I know P is perception. Steady. S is steady. Okay, steady perception. E is effortless. Lovely loveliness. Or effortless liquid light. Or effortless love and light. You can use those three different ones. Or, it's variations. Spell. Right? And then what's the opposite of that? What's the inverse? So inverse is insanity. And what does insanity tell us? That the continuity problem is solved because we're avoiding it. We're decided to stay in existence forever, therefore there is no continuity problem. That's insanity. I said, yeah. And so I'm right back, pulled myself right back into the ball game. You know, my mind was like straying. I said, I don't know any spiritual truth. I said, I'm under a spell. Spell. Steady perception of effortless liquid light. And zoom, right back in it. Incredible technique. And the other technique, of course, I've always said is, it's too late for that. So you can say for something, look, did it come in time or did it come too late? So this world, all the world problems, did they arrive in time to get you or did they arrive too late? And you put yourself in the driver's seat, you can say, no, they arrived too late. All these things that are supposed to drag me down, they came too late. All these mandates and pressures telling you what you have to do, it came too late for me. It missed me. It came too late. Incredible, powerful technique. It came too late. It arrived too late. Had already set sail, as it were. Knocks the wind out of it. So these are two profoundly helpful techniques that I have managed to accept from the Holy Spirit. Everybody's a little better behaved here on the freeway. All right. What can you do, right? I mean, there's not much you can do. We are in the commute. Nudity's problem has been... So I'm drifting now a little bit. I'm under a spell. Spell, steady perception of effortless, lovely loveliness by the Holy Spirit. So the Holy Spirit's salvation. Need to normalize this. And you're not really then thinking about the tension, the stress. All that came too late for you. Oh, it came too late for me. All the suffering, it came too late for me. All this insanity came too late for me. Came too late. I missed it. It missed me. It missed me. I was too late for me. It missed. Missed the target here. It was too late. That's a very powerful, effective technique here. Yeah. It missed me. All the troubles missed me. All the troubles missed me. All the troubles missed me. Illusion missed me. Insanity missed me. Continuity problem missed me. Avoidance of the Holy Spirit missed me. Delay missed me. It came too late. All delay came too late for me. All delay came too late for me. How about that one? All delay came too late for me. So maybe this traffic jam here is actually going to turn out to be helpful. That gives me an opportunity to practice these techniques. I took an alternative route home today, which I've never taken before, and it turned out to be a disaster as far as traffic goes, even though someone told me it was the best route possible, saved you like 20 minutes. it's adding like 40 minutes to my commute here. Just crazy. So, you know, not all, you know, not everything that people say, it works. But I said, wow, this certainly didn't work. So I test out stuff myself. The spell thing works. It's been fabulous for me. The too late thing works incredible. It is profound. I've been doing that for weeks now. And I can immediately feel a response throughout my whole system, as it were, that it is having some effect somewhere in a very strong way. Where are we at now? We're making some progress. Very, very cool day today. Like winter almost. Warmed up a little bit in the afternoon. But I think it's the middle of summer right now. But no. A big cool down here. Spell. I'm under a spell. I just drifted. What a spell. It is perceptions. P.S. Steady. Steady perception. He is a steady perception of effortless, lovely loveliness. The loveliness itself is lovely. And it's like double loveliness, as it were, this lovely loveliness. That is the charm. It's not just, we see a lot of charm in the world. We see loveliness here, but we don't see lovely loveliness. That is different. Wow, look at this. Starting to flow right here. Amazing. How did that happen? We see the Holy Spirit will show us a lovely loveliness. We can say that all the loveliness in the world came too late for me. It came too late. Yeah, for some reason it's all going smooth right now. Spell, and what are the two L's? I had one, loveliness, but what's the other L? And I said, just make it lovely loveliness. That is just totally profound, actually. Seeing clearly, I'll just take a drug, you'll see lovely loveliness. That's what the ego's telling people. You'll say, they're just, it's the lost world, it's an ego-based world, for sure it is. No doubt about it. A world that is very strict, you gotta get the job done, and you require something. So many young people being led astray or leading themselves astray and wasting the most valuable years of their lives when they could be energetically entering into the path of clarification and with great discipline and determination making great strides. Instead, they're taking the ego's way, and the ego tells them, here's a shortcut, just use drugs. And you'll have some, you know, you'll feel like, oh, everything is like so lovely, you know, wow, look at that. That kind of thing. It's like, this all seems different. Everything seems different. It seems altered. You know, like, oh, my perception's altered. But it's not the Holy Spirit's altering. It's not the lovely loveliness. You might say everything's so lovely, but you're not seeing the lovely loveliness. And it's that which is all important. So it doesn't give you what you need. It just wastes time and makes you think that you got what you need. And then you just say, well, I just wait and just take more drugs and just try to, you know, just wait and get it again and again and again. And then that's it. It's just a dead end. It's a dead end. Drugs are a dead end. But this is not something that the world wants to hear anymore. It's amazing. That the ego insists, no, it knows better. I mean, the world has to be listening to the ego. It has to be, because the Holy Spirit will never tell you that drugs are the way. Never. No way. No how. Nobody that's truly, you know, accepted the Holy Spirit's perception. Nobody, none of them are going to say that drugs are the way. They never have. They never will. I'll tell you very explicitly, no, absolutely not. That is not the way. So who is it that knows better than those who have succeeded? Is there someone who knows better? The ego knows better? Or is the ego insane? And tells you the way to salvation is to avoid the Holy Spirit and its perception. Obviously, that's what it's saying. It says you don't have a gigantic advantage. So we have all these holy, you know, sacred cows in the record books. And we say, well, they did it clean, you know. No, they didn't. They cheated like crazy. They were gobbling amphetamines. They'd take them, you know, to get up for the game, and they were like maniacs during the game, full of energy. Just like the German soldiers gobbled methamphetamine during World War II. And they were just animals. People are scared of them. They're crazy, you know. People act very crazy after 5 days up on methamphetamine. So these players are heroes, you know, these great baseball players. All these guys now, these steroid guys, are getting all this flack, and they're not kept out of the Hall of Fame and all this kind of stuff. But a lot of the players in the Hall of Fame after World War II, after World War II, got their numbers from amphetamines, period. And prior to World War II, they got it from other means, you know. They use whatever means they could. Nowadays, of course, it's both steroids and energy drinks and amphetamines if they can use them. But that's banned now, so you can get, you know, penalized for that. But they certainly just chug energy drinks. So whatever it takes to, you know, to get the edge. And so society in general is very much amped up, especially on caffeine. Just to try and get the edge. It's all about the edge in society now, isn't it? We're very edgy. We're not friendly like we used to be, because we're looking to see, you know, how can we get the edge? How can we get the edge? We were taught growing up, it's all about getting the edge. You've got to do something to get the edge here. So, tend to become very competitive. The secret to, and the secret to, you know, the kind of society of prosperity really was built on drugs. Certainly, the high-tech thing was built on drugs, and so was the post-World War II situation. Was strongly built on drugs. People were chugging black coffee and all the time, and there was widespread use of pep pills, they called them. I mean, President Kennedy was just completely drugged out. All of that. Of course, the head disciplinarian was my dad. It was my dad who was so strict. Again, and he suffered tremendous stress because of it. Because society rejected this attitude so much. You're behind the times, they say. Meaning you're not getting the edge. You're not getting the pep. Meaning you're falling behind the times, the pace. You're falling behind the pace. Well, guess what? Guess what? Falling behind the pace is not such a bad thing. Because I found a different pace. I found the fact that steady perception of effortless loveliness is the answer. I found what salvation must be. I found the truth. I found the facts, which require this calm, not a forced calm, but just a serious, quiet looking. Looking. It's called inquiry, looking. Satsang is looking. And I was a great looker. I spent my whole life just look at it. Don't leap to conclusions, don't leap to action, don't do anything. Just look. Just looking. Nothing more. Not even reacting. Just looking. Reactions tend to move on to action. It's just a situation where you're not acting, you're not deciding, you're not doing anything, you're just looking. Period. That's it. Nothing more than just looking. I'd sit on a bench at downtown and just for hours and hours and hours every day and just look. Just look. Just look at people going by. Just look at it. Just looking. Not doing anything except just looking. And then you find that you see all this behavior and stuff that's going on that you've never even noticed before. And you say, whoa, the world is not anything like we're told it is. It just sort of opens your mind and say, wow, I'm missing a lot. I don't really understand. I could maybe not understand a whole lot of what's going on. And that's just the beginning. As you practice looking, and then you look within, it's even more important. Looking within. Say, okay, you want to look? Here, just look at people. Be a people watcher. But that can be problematic, actually. Whereas the Holy Spirit would say, look within. I mean, look at your mental, look at your belief systems, the play of belief, the play of your thoughts, where you're going with your thoughts. Why are you suddenly avoiding this? How come you're thinking this way? Pay attention to your attention. Pay attention to your attention. Pay attention to your attention.